Assalamu alaikum. Today, inshallah, I'm going to talk about a very important topic also, which is birr al-walidayn. The meaning of a word birr is a very important word, came in the Quran. It talk about how not just obey your parent, obey is worshipping, but and not worshipping, you know, listening to them and do whatever they want. But birr is more, you know, you do things before even they ask you to do. And you see what the hell they like things and you do it. And for that reason, today I'm going to start my lesson with the stories. The story of today is Ali ibn Abi Talib. One day he's in the Kaaba praying with his son Hasan al-Hasan, and they hear the man crying so bad and pleading to Allah, asking for forgiveness. And Ali said to his son, go and tell him that God is full, he forgive everything, don't cry like this. And Hasan went to the man and said, my dad said it's okay, God forgive you. And he said, accept my sins, I did something so horrible and God will never gonna forgive my sins. Ali asked his son to bring this man and he will listen to his story. The story that he is a man from Yemen. He used to be a very good boy and subhanAllah, he got with bad people or bad friends. And in the end, he become coming late to the house and dad every time standing up asking him, how are you, what you did, why are you coming late, did you pray? And he answered yes. And one time he came late so much, and then dad asked him, did you pray Aisha? And he said, no. And then father said, you coming late again and you don't even pray? And he felt so mad from him, he want to hit him. And that second, he pushed his dad away from him and pushed his hand, you know, like he pushed him out in a very bad. And for that reason, from this push, father raised his hand and said, God, please scribble this hand who raised on me. And from that day, his hand couldn't move. His right hand couldn't move. From age of 16 until when he is now, when he's a man, 25 years old, his hand is crippled. Dad asked Allah for forgiveness. The boy becomes so good, but subhanAllah, Allah not accepted anything, and the boy is crippled. Until one day, the father and the son said, okay, how about we go to a Hajj, we go to the Kaaba, ask God if that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our dua, two of us, and I will play to him, and I will say I forgive him, and maybe God will accept it. And in the end, when the boy bring his dad from Yemen, walking all this distance until they reach Mecca before hours, dad felt so tired and he want to eat. The boys try to tie the camel to the tree that fell down on a rock and hit his head and died. And now the only chance that this man could have a hand who is good, that he will be a forgiving and God will forgive him and he can move his hand, his dad, and his dad already died. And he went to the Kaaba and he started crying and praying. Imam Ali said, we're gonna all pray with the intention of your dad. If Allah, if your dad have a good intention that he will forgive you, then maybe we will pray and God will help you and return back your hand again. And they prayed and thank God in the end, his hand returned back. Look at us, how many times, guys, we are disrespecting our parents these days. I feel that children or youth or a lot of us even, we never feel how much is, you know, parent is important to us. And for that reason, I need to remind you that please try to make your parent happy from you. You know that there is five things could be blessed by just doing it. First, that there's two doors in heaven opened and their name is Al-Birr, and Allah will accept just from them, make you enter from them if you do take care of your parent. And second thing is, if you look at the eyes of your parent and be mercy to them, that's also going to make you enter heaven. And God said if the best job a person could do after praying in tongues is taking care of his parents and be nice to his parents. And the four things is, it's a very important that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best, the heaven under the feet of your parent, and especially your mom. And although this hadith is weak, but we need to make sure that all of us take care of our parent. I'm gonna give you 8 tips quickly how to be nice to your parent. First is, please talk with them and respectfully, guys. Those people used to listen to you hours and they feel, oh good, thank you so much. Please, I need you to respect your parent. I need you to look at them with mercy. I need you to, when they walk behind them, I need you to not raise your voice, even if they make you angry. Go to the room and come back. I need you to make them feel happy. I need you to keep saying good words. God bless you. Make dua for them. God make you. God will accept your deed, Baba. God, your make your life happy, Mama. Always make dua verbally or in salah. Please try to don't interrupt and don't argue. Thank you so much, and God bless you. Assalamu alaikum.